hope everybody is doing well. I thought I'd do a FaceTime video today. I wanted to do a tour of this build that I did. This is my rooftop Zen cafe. It's for the I Heart Japan collab. I was going to do like a cinematic tour, but I don't have much time. So I just thought I'd jump on and do a live one, and hopefully you guys will not get bored of me. So this is the rooftop Zen cafe. I built it for the I Love Japan collab. It was hosted by Erin with a Y, and I highly recommend you go check out her YouTube. She's done like a cinematic tour of the exteriors of all the builds. It was a huge save file with like 45 different builders. I'll also link and put all their details below so you can check any of those out. You can check it out on Instagram. I'll pop the hashtag in the description. You can check it out on the gallery. Again, I'll put the hashtag in the description, and you can download the save file from the underneath of Erin's video for her save file tour. So basically what I'm saying is go and check the description out to read everything, and then yeah, this is my build. So we all got given a lot. So basically it's Mount Komurebi and Sanmaishuno. So I was in the Sanmaishuno bunch where we kind of d turned the city into like Tokyo inspired. So obviously this is very much inspired. It's our own take on it. Hopefully we did it justice. I also had an apartment. If you want to see my last video, I have an apartment. That was my original lot, and I got it finished. Was real pleased with myself because I got it done early, and then about 4 days before the collab was due to go live, Erin said she had a lot that was empty, she needed it filling, and I stupidly volunteered, and this is what I built on it. I'm actually really pleased because this is not what I was originally going to do. I was going to place an existing build on here and then just edit it so it fitted properly and looked nice. But the existing build looked absolutely naff when I dropped it down. So I ended up just bulldozing it and starting from scratch. So let's have a look. So it's like a multifunctional lot. I wanted to do a lot of landscaping because the plants and things that we got in the Snowy Escapes pack are just so pretty. And we got these really cool, like the monkey statues. These, is it a Shinto? I can't clone it. I've been spoilt by the tool mod's cloning ability, and I've took it out of my game because of the update broke it. So I can't clone it, but I'm pretty sure it's a Shinto gate. So yeah, it's a multifunctional lot. We have two buildings. So this building over here is my traditional tea house. I'll show you inside there first. As you can see, we've got like cute little tables outside so you can go grab a coffee and then sit and enjoy the view. I kind of wanted it to be like an oasis in the city because I imagine living, I mean, I don't live in a city, but I would find it probably quite stressful and want some greenery and stuff. So that's why I thought this was like a really nice idea for people to come and have a coffee and get away, that kind of thing. So we've got like the usual set up for coffees, etc. And then in the back here, I wanted to go for a more traditional sort of tea room. So I placed all these nice, these are called, oh, I don't even know if I could say that. Kotashu? I'm really bad at this. I'm not even gonna try. So yes, I got these really nice tables. These came with Snowy Escapes, and I'm pretty sure the sort of traditional Japanese tables. And the cute little hot pots. So these are really good because your sim can come in, because I play tested it, the sim can come in and just like brew a hot pot and sit and chill, which I thought was a really nice idea. I also added in the fireplaces, which is probably a total safety faux pas, but when they're lit, it just looks so cute. I could imagine this in winter. I didn't actually put it in winter on my game, but maybe I should, because I imagine if it's snowy outside, it'd be like a really nice place to come and have a little hot pot. Yeah, so there's like obviously racks for your clothes and for your jackets and coats and shoes, because I imagine that you wouldn't have your shoes on these mats because respect and stuff, you know. And then upstairs, obviously more of the same. And then outside on the terrace, nice. We've got the cute little tables, which look nice. And then I did like a picnic area, so people can enjoy the greenery basically. And this cool, I love these picnic tables with the thing. Oh, honestly, I don't know when I placed it. So if this might happen for you guys, if you download the save file, but when it's downloaded, for some reason this corner didn't have any flooring and it was also missing a railing, so you just pop it back. Sorry about that. Yeah, so got these lovely picnic tables for people to enjoy the view. I mean, it is awesome. I just love it. Like, if I was a sim, I'd be well happy sat there having a coffee. Just like, that's the karaoke bar that Joe built, and it's amazing. So you could like sit and watch people going and doing karaoke. Yeah, and then I decided to put this little pergola in the corner, and underneath is a little seating area. I don't know if you can see that. There we go. It's really my camera keeps wanting to go dodgy because I'm on the top of a building. Yeah, so this is the little seating area in the corner, as well as more seating here. And it looks really nice at night time. Let's get night time. There we go. I've got like all pretty lights and stuff. I made sure the planting had lots of little night, like these little lights inside them and stuff. And I think it looks really cool. I'm like tooting my own horn here a bit, but I'm pretty damn pleased with how it turned out for the time in which it took me. Yeah, so we've got like the little pergola there with the seating area, and then obviously when I bulldozed my previous build and started it, I had no clue what it was going to look like. So I took myself to Pinterest and found some inspiration pictures, and there was this really cool Zen garden with like stairs above it, and it was like a walled Zen garden, and it looked so good. So that was my inspiration for this. So basically, this building here in the very top is where the sim comes in, because obviously if it's a residential, not residential, if it's a cafe, so it's a community lot, so the sims just turn up. So the sim comes in here. We've got obviously like vending machines, somewhere to sit if you're meeting your friend, tourist information board, of course. And then I thought this cool, these are from Island Living. So you can see the Zen garden, which I thought was a quite a nice thing. I went for all like glass because I didn't want to obscure the view. It was all about the views and the planting. And yeah, so I went for this walled Zen garden. And I'm pleased with how it turned out. It's quite a nice area just for the Sims to come and relax. I know like Sims don't really need to do that because I really appreciate it, but I appreciate it. And then there's this cute little wishing board, which is from the Snowy Escapes pack as well. The Sims can like take a selfie with it, they can make a wish, and they can view it. And I think they can make a wish on this cute little bamboo as well. But yeah, it's just a sort of a somewhere for the Sims to come and be mindful, which is quite fitting with the new update for the Spa Day pack. So then this building here, obviously we know the top is where the Sims come in. I decided to make it like a little wellness center, because I thought, like, because it's a Zen cafe and a Zen top garden, maybe people want to go find some Zen and relax. So in here, I actually did this twice because when I first did it, I got it all laid out all nice. It looked awesome, and then I realized I forgot the stairs. Hands up if you do it all the time. I'm the person that forgets either the stairs after they finish the whole build, or the toilet, or like the outdoor trash can, all the time without fail. Now I tend to save stuff and then go back to it later and then check that I've got everything in place. So yeah, so I had to rearrange it. We've got like the reception desk, which I was thinking that people would make appointments for classes and stuff. We've got the toilets, we've got the changing rooms, and we've got the showers. It's all fully functional because I checked it before I sent it to Erin. And then in here we have a yoga room. So when you download it, the yoga mat that the instructor uses is just a standard one because I made this before the Spa Day update. But now with the new update, you can place these cool instructor mats, and your sim can come here and like host a class and get paid for it, which is really fun because it's like the Sims rented the room, you know, like they could, I mean, it's not actually a career, but they could do it as a job. So I'm really pleased with that, and I'm going to play with that in my actual gameplay. And I honestly had no idea that was happening when I built this build. So it's like I had a psychic moment with The Sims. But yeah, so you can do that. Also, you could delete all of the yoga mats, and you could put whatever you wanted. You could put gym equipment in here. You could put painting stuff in here if you decided you wanted it to be like an art room instead. You know, whatever. Doesn't really matter. And then upstairs here, it's obviously quite a basic room, but I didn't want to like put too much stuff in it. This is just the meditation room, and again, your sim can use the new Spardate update, and they can host meditation classes and stuff, which go towards the aspirations, the new ones. So I was really pleased with that. I can't put it in live mode because I've not got a sim on the lot, but this fountain sounds awesome. It sounds really cool and relaxing. But again, you could take the seats out, and you could put like the what are they called? The new spa day stuff in. So there's like all the new chairs that we got. If you've got the spa day pack, you could pop those in and have it like a massage relaxation room. You could have it as a nail tech room, a gym, again, like whatever you want. You could even put a bed in there and move in. I don't know, whatever you want to do. So that is my build. So I'm sorry it's not like a pretty cinematic tour. They actually take a surprising amount of time to edit because I'm a bit of a newbie at editing and stuff. So that's why I haven't had time to do one. But I hope you like the build. You can download it in the save file, as I said. If you actually want just the build and not the save file, it's on the gallery under my ID, which is Mardy Yardy. And I'm going to be posting the pictures that I took on Instagram. If you want to come across and like say hi, I always like to talk to people. But I'm also going to do a slideshow, I think, right now, of some pictures that I took with my reshade on, and you can see what it looks like. So I hope you're all having a good day, and that you have a nice weekend because it's almost Friday. And I'll speak to you all soon.